We pray in the name of the Almighty God, Yahweh, Lord Jesus Messiah, God, Holy Spirit, Amen. In the most holy name of the Lord Jesus Messiah, begotten Son of God, and we search for the truth, and we can have the truth and the wisdom and comfort from God, Holy Spirit, for the greater glory of God, Father, Yahweh. We pray that we may be able to understand and inculcate in our very heart, mind, and soul, spirit, the significance, the importance of the forthcoming election, May 2016. In the name of the Almighty God, Yahweh, Lord Jesus Messiah. Amen. Good morning, mga pahinga-aga, magandang umaga. Sa Balker, will I come salam, no matter what. So, this is Shepherd Everlet Albevelarde giving unto you her sosa, the shepherd, the state of the shepherd address, sosa. Shepherd of the Messianity congregation, or for those who believeth in the Messiah, the true religion that must characterize the religion that I have been fighting for ever since, and the religion that had been blocked by the Zambians family. So here we stand, your shepherd, Fem Mipab Everlet Pulin, with my children, the 4K9 gem of God, Kevin Edel, Imedrian, Casey May, Clint Jan. They are also my treasures, and further known as the 4K9 gem of God, because they also have their own calling just like me. So to start with, good morning. Again, a blessed and a pleasant day to each and everyone. It is April 12, 2016, Tuesday, in the year of God, Holy Spirit. We are in my home office here in second floor, 47 the C Private Road, Santo Niño Extension Street, Barangay 6-A, Province of Leyte, Tacloban City, Philippines. 6500, telephone number 321-1643. So election. Why do we have to have an election? This is an impromptu talk, but I just want to give the thoughts from the very beginning why we have this kind, why we should have an election, why we should have this kind of government, and how our leaders are running our nation, something like that. Especially that we also file our candidacy, and as a citizen of this nation and resident of this city, we have the right to speak. So why there should be an election? Election is choosing a leader. We choose a leader to what? To guide us, to lead us. I remember my DVD to President Barack Obama. I don't know if it reached him, the original DVD that I have. I say it, sir, we are on mission. We are leaders. You are the President of the United States of America. I also am a leader of the sect or the religion that we must have. In other words, my forte is faith. So my goal is conversion and salvation. I also am a leader like you. But we lead our people in different manner, in different power and authority. To become a leader, yes, we should have the capacity to lead leaders, to lead our people. Meaning to say, if you are a leader, you are somehow a model. You should have that modeling career. Huh? The morals, the values, we should pass. And those values that we have must be in accordance to the law of God. Leadership, friendship. Be a friend. You should not only be concerned of those who are your cronies, your people. Those who are living people, all must survive. If you are after salvation and if you are pro-life, not just narcissistic, thinking all about yourself, your femininity, your fame, your power, that is not your power. You just take that power from somebody else, something like that. To be a friend is, you are someone who is on top and you go down for them. In telespirit, I told President Aquino, sir, if you're already on top and then you keep on climbing the stairs, whom are you going to talk with if you are there on top? And your people are there. Your people gonna just come up. So you have to go down and call them. Do not look up on me. Come up. Come up. They are your people, your friend. Service. To be a leader, you will serve the people. To serve is not to corrupt. You give yourself, you give your time, your effort, your skill. You give everything. You serve. So, to be a leader is, there is leadership, friendship, service. Quoted by the law of God, known as faith. So that is election for me, choosing a leader. That is why in our risograph for our campaign material, I said, your vote is sacred. To apply it in the Bible, the Lord said, you don't have to make so many rules. You don't have in our time to choose somebody who is a lawyer, who is a master of arts, who is PhD degree. What we need is a leader who have wisdom. Wisdom is hard to grasp, right? It's hard to find wisdom. It is the reason why to find a good leader is a tough decision making. What if there are no leaders, there are no good leaders around? And they do not allow 20 candidates. They do not allow 10 candidates. You cannot choose. There are only 4 or 5 candidates. Your vote is sacred. Because if you vote someone, somebody else, whom you know they are immoral, it is already a sin, a very big sin for you, epic, voters, that you have voted for the wrong person. And that if they persecute you, oppress you, and put you down to hell, that's the time for you to think you did not vote for the right leader. So vote is sacred. This is our risograph. My running for mayor. Why I ran for mayor? First and foremost, it was not my choice. Even before I could hear and want me to become one because they can hear me planning all these things. I have this access. I am the original. There are those who believe. Then I saw in the Facebook, Cristina Romualdez was running for mayor. I laugh so hard. She has that shameless face, really, to file for mayor, despite what she is doing, had been doing. What is she doing now? What she is doing now with her platoon? First and foremost, that platoon are the immorals, that polygamous, that adulterers, that lesbianism, homosexualism, bisexualism. That is the sin, the original sin of people, not of Satan. God hates the people very much. That fucking system. Let me speak the right word. That fucking system killeth the mind of the people, of the world leaders, because of that fucking system. Do not forget the name Cristina Gonzalez Romualdez, Jenny Lynn Chu, Mrs. Velarde, Mrs. Romualdez et al. Both of them have et al. Husbands, racial and local. They are the first two women cursed by God. The first two women whom you love and believe so much. Do not forget them. So why? I am a sacrifice. That Islamic State, those Muslims, the Al-Qaeda, the Pentagon, the EPIC, they giveth that evaluation to me that make me run. It is not a cargo, yung tawag natin dyan, Taconsuelo de Bobo. It's not Taconsuelo de Bobo effect or kind of evaluation. I can evaluate myself. You can also give a self-examination. Correct? So, they verbalized who I am, and I knew who I am. Since we jive, then I say, I am not lifting my own chair, my own Banco de Oro. There are others who say it so. So, I go. I go. I am a sacrifice, and it is not because of that salary. How much is the salary for mayor? That I even do not know. My salary when I was clinical instructor part-time, I was able to receive 20,000 a month. So, that 20,000 is good enough. Our business now is this house, second floor, boarding house, and we have some commercial space for lease in my hometown, Alang-Alang, Leyte. I cannot have a job because every time I have the job here and abroad, that Cristina Romualdez and Jenilyn Paklawan Paniki will always find a way to block my job. And my going to Mindanao, my going to Davao, was me, by the way, who had written to the chairman of Bangsamoro, Chairman Sayid Lingayen, but who are going there? Who get the response? That was the beginning of the chaos in Mindanao. They are the imposters who go there. This is the original who had a deal with Bangsamoro, and as well as Davao. I have a spiritual, religious concern that I must go to Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. Anyway, and somehow, We are friends. He had sent me 3 envelopes coming from their kingdom, the kingdom of Jesus, the Bao. Somehow, we are also friends. So, I think I can go. So, there are problems with regards to our going there. And it is because of the impostors. I forgot my microphone. Anyway, it's not a salary, because if the Romualdeses did not corrupt my properties, the inheritance that I have, we have so much money. We have 80,000 per harvest in our 12 hectares. It is 35 hectares. Where are the other hectares? Always remember this one. They are saying I am glutton. It was given to me by my father. And they agree that I get the 35 hectares because I was the one who relocated and was able to relocate where is the 35 hectares. Even the geodetic civil engineer, Edelberto Jr. Velarde, brother that we have, we're not able to find it. It is the nurse, the woman, and I did it alone. But I was guided by the Majesty, the Lord Santo Niño. That is why I was able to. It is in my name, the 35. I am going to give the 22 hectares to the Messianian people only. When we say Messianian, they are those who believeth in the Lord Jesus Messiah and shall belong to our sect. But they cannot have the documents in their name. They cannot. It will be chaotic and it will be a mess and a problem, just like Hacienda Luisita of the Aquinos. But the CARP started from the late President Cory Aquino. And they were the first who cannot obey their comprehensive agrarian reform program. So we still have our 35 hectares. How come I am corrupt if I will only get 12 hectares of the 35? The money will go to the people, but the proprietorship shall be in my name. Whereas the 12 hectares shall be retained in the name of my father, who giveth me and my children that inheritance. It was bought 1971. It is not a property of Al-Qaeda Pentagon. There is no property that I have coming from Al-Qaeda Pentagon. Remember that even a single dollar I do not have, I didn't receive. My name is being dragged as a swindler because it is in my name, the money that we have here. But the Romualdeses and the Platon are enjoying, toying, mocking me. And they pretend to be the originals. Their shameless faces. But this face can face anybody. Up to Nigeria, Africa, and to all continents, and to whomever leaders who would like to talk to me as the visionary and the trustee of their money, because it is a World Bank. It is an international monetary fund. I rejected the money. It was the finance minister of Nigeria who insisted that I must accept the offer. I did try. And the process was very speedy. It was fast. But look what happened. The mistake there was the scan. The scan. So that was the mistake there in their process. So it is not money. I have. So 5,988,000 is the corruption of Alfred Romualdez Platon to me from my inheritance. I present the documents and the computation. They cannot face me in City Hall and in Sangguniang Bayan of Tacloban to prove if I am kulanting, if I have a mental defect, or who really have that mental is in mental instability. I am alone. I am fighting against his, their policemen, against their armies, against their scalawags, against their tentacles. Even my children, I am already fighting with my children. We don't fight like that before, but just because of those confabulated stories they are doing, we now have quarrels in the house. It is not money. I have money. I have also an inheritance in America. I also am the heir or the trustee of the property in Manila, Pasay City, and it is million. My property in Alang-Alang is also 4 million, and Cristina Romualdez would like to buy it at 2 million from the money that I have. According to our document, I have 180 million from Nigeria. But what did I receive? 5,988,000 corruption and persecution. And they are trying to prove I am an impostor. So I am a sacrifice to you, Tacloubanans, to you, Litenios, to you, Philippines, to the world. That if I could be in that position, we can settle, put into right order the law. We do not have law anymore here and there. There is no law anymore in Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and even the other countries are already affected, even America, because of the Pentagon's invasion to Tacloban City. What is very bad there was the husbandry of Jackson Pierre and Cristina Romualdez. Her head swells. Her head swells. She was a spoiled. But when Thompson met me in Robinson's Maras Baras, that was the time the insecurity of Cristina Romualdez popped up. And I do not know if Jackson Pierre really got murdered or was he sent away. That is why I keep on asking the armies of America if he is still okay with Secretary Mark Halley, Armed Forces of America. That's how I knew him. We can how will I run Tacloban if ever? I was born, I always emphasize this one, I was born September 21, 1972, Martial Law Day, when the late President Ferdinand Idralin Marcos declared martial law. They see martial law as bad communism. But when I tried to ponder all these things out, I find martial law beautiful. It is not true that it was bad. What I could see, martial law would like to protect the people. Irregardless what could be the cause of the rebellion, it was to protect the nation. So there will be martial law every day in Tacloban City. Policemen will not be scalawags as they are now. I will have my own RCK-10M policemen and women. They should not be polygamous. They should not be bisexuals. They should be Messianian. that mentality and spirit of a Messiah niyan. RCK10M is another faction, just like Al-Qaeda, Taliban, ISIS, ISIL, Communist Party, Pentagon. But it is a religious faction. It is not all about war. It is not all about the economy of the country. It is all about salvation, justice. Justice is the very first motto of the RCK 10. And of course, in faithfulness to the faith, to the Lord. That is RCK 10. So, to be a sacrifice is to neutralize to neutralize all the people. If ever there will be segregation, it will only be the bad and the good. The good and the bad. That is the segregation I am going to do. But because I am Al-Qaeda, I am a Muslim adopted. I belong to the Islamic States. I am a friend of Muslims. I also am Pentagon because they also trusted me. And there is also another from China, from Baba Jinping Xi. There is also from President Putin, Vladimir. There is also from United Kingdom. There was a declaration from Prime Minister Michael Gorbachev of USSR. They believe it. Even the Pope believeth, the two popes that we have. The problem is the manipulation, that I am the impostor. So, friends, classmates, mentors, relatives, who I am. Is this Everlet Alve Velarde? I am. If I am not Everlet Alve Velarde, whom they say impostor, where is Everlet? And if I am not Everlet, who I am? Who I am? It is always my question for those who say I am impostor. Remember Alfred Romualdez, you gave an autopsy report. You declare I was drowned. You declare I am dead. And you kill my father, Edilberto Sr. Velarde, November 2013. And how come there was a father of mine whom you say he was there in August 2015 in St. Peter's? And when I go there with my eldest son, Kevin, August 7, my father is not the one who is in the casket. He is not in the casket. Are you playing with the dead? You don't respect anymore, CIDG, you are suspect. PNP, you are the companion of Cristina Romualdez to get the money in Abuja, Nigeria. It was not the original contract. That is why they knew you are impostors. Estelle Velarde was the one who replaced me in going there. It was not the original contract. I should not go to Abuja. They are to deliver it to me, door to door. Policemen and women, you are the companion of Cristina Romualdez and the impostors to get the trunk of money. And the trunk of money was recovered by U.S. Army, he declared in television. That was the best contribution, he said, he did to Tacloban. They were able to find the trunk of money, and I'm very much sure it was the trunk of Nigeria. Because the Pentagon is through trunk line, bank. But Nigeria doesn't like bank-to-bank transaction. They told me they met a lot of problems. It is pentagons that you are getting from the bank. But Dr. Olunsugon Aganga became the governor of World Bank. That money is now known as International Monetary Fund. You are now corrupting directly the World Bank. That is how notorious. And you are the terrorist now. Idilito Alve Velarde, my younger brother, declared in the Vision Devil. I swear to God. And his wife, who is a fucking whore, Jenny Lynn Chuma de Raso, the Pegaso dancer on her early minarchy days, and up to now, she was not able to graduate to that prostitution. She is maniac. She is the wife of Idilito Velarde. I don't have incest relationship. I don't have a boyfriend. I don't have a husband. I only have 4 children. And my 4th is salvation and the mission. So, these 2 spouses, Alfred Cristina Romualdez, Idilito Jenny Lynn Paklawan Paniki, are the first evils. They are the terrorists. They can go to any countries. They have the jet. They can just go into a country just like that. They can enter Malacanang just like that. They can go to Mindanao just like that. They can change documents just like that. I will switch off the internet because they can corrupt my file. Okay, so I will be multifunctional mayor. This is not a campaign. This is an explanation. Multifunctional leader. It is my promise, just as Al-Qaeda admitted me or allowed us to go to their safe house. So, they are not terrorists. No. That is why you, Al-Qaeda, you, Pentagon, do not fight each other. The terrorists here in Tacloban, they are the ones who would like you to fight. And they don't like me to go there because their popularity, their femininity, their corruption will stop if I will be there. And I can go to Pentagon. And I can go to Baba China. I am her baby China. So the arms they send from China, which is addressed to second floor, wala yan sa akin. Romualdez Platoon. Their PNP, their BGMP, take it, those arms. And we have to talk about it later. So if I could be in that, if I could, that is their fear for me to go out of this country because I could go anywhere. My going anywhere is not to build a platoon of rebels to retaliate to them. Retaliation is a foolish term. I don't retaliate. I don't. But know the limits. Know the limits. I can go to Communist Party. The President of Germany, President Gott, giveth me the blessing. I could read the Nazi constitution that they have. My purpose is to check because of Hitler's, they say Hitler is evil. That is why we are to correct whatever needs to be corrected. That is my purpose. Communist China, it was posted in internet. I was able to read. There is no problem with their law. So it is in Germany that I would like to see. So thank you, President Go, for the approval. I said, if I cannot go to Germany because of these foolish people, the army of Germany sent to me your book. I can do it here. And I will jump to another topic. That federal governance system Duterte would like to have. I disagree. My way is factional. When we say factional, it doesn't it don't mean there is a formal legal declaration of the factions, because the one faction that is to stand then is the RCK10 Messianian. But the Al-Qaeda, the Pentagon, the blah 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 can still stand as whom they are. If we come to that a conversion of faith, that of Messianity, that is the time for us. We are going to have our own soldiers in the RCK10M. We have our own lawyers, our own army, our own pilots, our own lawyers, teachers, engineers, doctors, something like that, in the RCK10. And that factional that I'm to go with is we are the giver of justice. We are the avenger. That is what I mean, a factional system or government, not federal. I really could see it's a foolishness to turn Philippines as a federal system. So I said, we are the socialite beggars. Socialite beggars to be in a government system that are federal. PAL. And it's very copal to be in that federal. So factional. I will not elaborate, but in one sentence, I say I could be with Al-Qaeda, Pentagon, Communist parties of the nations, and we will be the avenger of justice according to the law of God, not according to our rationalization. That is the difference of being the original visionary in the law of God than those who are impostors trying to say they can be like me. No, no, no. Morality pa lamang and immorality. We are already north and south. I am in the north. You are absolutely in the south, the bottomless pit. We cannot be the same. Amen. Never. And the judgment of the Lord, I will obey. Whom he said zombie shall be zombie forever. No mercy, no forgiveness. BBL, retain BBL for Mindanao, for the Muslims. They need that autonomy. Do not allow. Because Duterte, dalawa ang salita. Tatanggalin ang BBL. Ngayon naman, minumungkahi niya sa President Aquino na pirmahan na daw yung BBL. Ang pagkaalam ko naman noon, pinirmahan na ng Aquino ang BBL. See? Yung ating media, yung ating Facebook, marami na rin mga problema. So, when I heard na gusto niyang tanggalin ang BBL, I said, no, you fight for that BBL, or else you will suffer that much again. You are Muslims. You are different from us. Although I am no Muslim, you are my friend. I've been to Arabia and I meet Muslims. They are not bad people, actually. We are not perfect, but they are not bad people. So I think mas maprinsipyo ang Muslim kaysa sa Kristiyano. Tama? That's why I think like Muslim, Al-Qaeda, Pentagon, Communist Party. Ganun ako mag-isip. Oh, that's good. Then you should salute me for that. Oh. Diba? So continue BBL. Fight for that. If I will win, how can I win? If they erase me in COMELEC. The people ask me, the election is fast approaching. Who is going to be your mayor? Mayor. I said, oh, you vote for Everlet Velarde. She is the best. She is top according to other evaluation. Yeah? She is not bopol. She is not tanga. Those who said they are intelligent, no. She is the one. It is not intelligence that she have. She has the righteousness and wisdom. Everlet is the best. You can find her there in second floor. But the problem is, she is not in the master's list of COMELEC here in Tacloban. But she filed that candidacy in 8th floor, Palacio del Gobernador, Intramuros, Manila, COMELEC. And the evaluation to her file was very good. Clinical instructor ka pala. Good. The only problem that we can see, according to the law department of COMELEC, was Cristina Romualdez. That haloperidol injection to me here, trespass to my house, was the other running for mayor, Kabudoy Hilda, under the instruction of Cristina Romualdez and Paklawan Paniki in the ground. The other running for mayor is Mr. Neil Glova. I don't say I endorse to him my becoming a mayor because the two women are immorals. You should not really vote for them. But I do not say vote for Neil Glova because he is also like Duterte. He could be controlled also. Duterte, I was the very first campaign manager of Duterte. I composed that jingle, President Rodrigo Duterte, with keyboard, with music. But I'm so disgusted of his being a weakling and immoral also. Especially that he did not fight for our going to Bangsamoro, to Davao. I reached Malacanang 3 times to borrow a chopper because the jet President Barack Obama had given to us is not in our custody. It's not under our power and authority. Under the corrupt in the ground. Even the firearm that FBI had secured for me, they all take it. All. FBI knew my life is in danger. Thank you, Texas. Thank you, Fred Amor. Even though, thank you. So, President Duterte, no. My president will be Pinay Santiago. My vice president is Bongbong Marcos. Even if you are Romualdez, Bongbong Marcos, I have a Facebook message to you yesterday. I said, if you are a sincere leader, you should find a loyal staff. The subordinates are the ones who destroy the leaders. When the subordinates awaken and awaken, Romualdez will go to the leaders to destroy their faith. That's it. That is why the soldiers come without the knowledge of their precedents. When they are killed here, they do not know their soldiers are here. So 300 missing soldiers from China, they were not able to go back after their step to Tacloban City. That was the reason Baba China gave us those arms. But where are those arms now? If they were able to reach the second floor, I could have a good deal with those arms. I know how to handle. What happened to those arms? Smuggled by Cristina Romualdez. Ano pang topic natin? Our Comelec filing. I am registered and then it was eventually erased. So I am not here in the master's list. So for the voters, I told them, if you believeth in Everlet, just vote for her, even if she is not in that. The problem for that will be if they knew you vote for me, wala kang trabaho, you are to lose your job. You will be persecuted. You will be poor like me, even if I have millions. You will be as poor as me. And how can you stand? Can you stand? Can you fight against them? That is the problem if you're going to fight. That is why we need avengers. Who will be the avenger now? How the election is going to must go. My suggestion in my previous DVD was it should be the armies who are to handle the election process. Ang tawag mo dyan, electoral board, table. And there should be manual, and if you are to use the PICOS machine, use also, but you still have to use the cartolina, the Manila paper, counting. There is a seal to prove it is the original. There will be a soldier who is in charge for that, and for the filing of those Manila papers, in 8 hours time, regular time, there will be a declaration. We have the computer system. We can immediately put on the figures so there will be no changes that are going to be made. If the teachers here, especially Tacloban, here will be the one to attend to this election process, Dadadamba Carmela Rojas Tamayo is second head of Commission on Higher Education, and she is also having a lesbianism relationship with Cristina Romualdez, and that even Chris Aquino confessed she have had with Cristina also. What are we going to have? What kind of nation are we going to have? Bisexuals, immoral, and remember in the Bible, Jerusalem was destroyed. It was the temple itself of God, because those people who are in his house are all immorals. So God, Yahweh, destroyed that temple in Jerusalem and rebuilt with the help of Greece. The same with us. This Philippines is already drowned by Yolanda. We need another nation to redeem this drowned city, this drowned nation. No matter how you try, you cannot have salvation unless the AOA shall rise. Ganon, basta army ang hahawak. Nandyan yung PICOS mo, nandito yung mga Manila paper mo. Lahat yan, sundalo ang hahawak kung ito ang ating classroom na pagboto. Ilan lang yung nandoon? Depende sa dami ng tao ng isang precinct. Oo. So 10, 15 people could come inside. And then there is a time allotment para sa kanila bumoto. Kapag hindi pa sila tapos, pero tapos na yung oras, yung tapos na ay isasalpak na doon sa machine. Likewise, count. The people could see, pag pumasok sila, yung susunod na boboto, they could see kung ilan na yung takbo ng election. So, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, tapos na. You still have how many hours na bilangin yan? Pag nabilang mo na yan, put it in the system. Declare in the radio stations. Huh? And then, yun na ang pwede kang ma-delay. Yung isang ano na yan, kunyari yung school ng, here we have here the Panalarun Central School. Diba? Yung ilang precinct yung nandiyan. 3 o'clock, lahat ng precinct ng Panalarun Central School, class, tapos na. So, kaya ano yan, iipunin na. Mayroon na namang in charge dyan sa Panalarun Central School. Isang army na magdideklara. Ito yung total. Oo. Tapos, magdideklara ulit siya. Oo. Tapos, yung every precinct naman, ay every, ang tawag mo dyan, pooling center. Every pooling center, isang school, Panalarun Central School, Cerelo, San Fernando, ganun, sa Tacloban. Mayroon isa na naman, dalawa o tatlo, na ano yan, kanila naman yan. Yung mga tapos na doon sa kanila, ibibigay lahat. Okay. Tapos, may isa na naman na sila ang magdadala ng mga, sila yung magsisil. Signature nila, stampad nila, at pag nandun, dry seal nila, to seal yung mga ballots na original. Kung mayroong reklamo, yun na yung time na we can reopen the box. It will be under the accountability responsibility of those armies. Armies! You, hindi dapat yung army na nandito sa Tacloban is from Tacloban. Dapat galing ka sa Mindanao, galing ka sa Manila, magpapalitan tayo. Wala tayong kilala. Ako, kung akong sundalo, hindi kita kilala. Ang alam ko lang, maski ako pumunta doon sa precinct, alam ko kung ano ang gagawin. Yung iba naman, sila ay magmamatsyag. Oo, maski may pulis, kung may pulis, sundalo ang gagalaw talaga. Yung ibang pulis, dapat magpapalitan din sa ibang pulis. Kasi, yan nga ano na yan. Pero minsan, buong Pilipinas nga, inako-control na siya dahil lang sa pera. So, this is to have an honest election. Whether i-vote ako or hindi, whether you're going to vote for me or not, I just want to let you know how our election, the face of election, the face of COMELEC, what do we have now? Compare before. Attorney Canlas is, my goodness, she did not allow me even registration, a biometric application form registration. It is very important and it is a must for all voters. Irregardless if I still have a record there or not, that I am a voter in the year 2013 election. There was a flood. There was death. There are missing people. And you say, I am dead, CIDG. You said, I have an autopsy. You don't want me to have my original fingerprints. Huh? All my documents, you confiscate. And then you replace with your impostor. That's why the world leaders were deceived. You do not use your power and authority correctly. PNP,
CIDG. Instead of doing atonement for your sins, that of Poblete, that of Pacheco, that of Abarca, your negligence, your pledge of allegiance, you don't have that one. You add more insult to your injury. So I'm very much sorry, PNP, that I cannot trust you. Because even a simple blatter, you cannot do it correctly. Very disappointing. The testimony I instructed, requested, and that is legal, PNP. I want Jenilyn Madrazo Chuvilarde and Idilito Velarde as caregivers of my father to give a testimony. Where is my father? When he died? How he died? Why? I do not know. Why they took my father here in second floor after me and my boarders saved my father? Idilito and Jenilyn Paniki were not giving food to my father after typhoon. They really want him to die. Then he was taken from me here in second floor without permission. I never heard from him again. He was my defender since I was a child. When he get old, I promised him and told him, I will be your defender this time. You were my defender when I was a child. Those brothers and sisters that I have, they are my enemies ever since. They are so envious of me. That is why my father defend me from them, even to my biological mother. There is no Oedipal Electra complex between me and my father. Because it's not only my father who liked me, who trusted me, my grandmother. That is why I am the first heir of this house. When we bought this house in late 80s, in the Pla, from Pla family, from Alang-Alang, the money that we have here is the money of my father, mother, my grandmother, and my aunties in America to buy this house. And because they are, meron yan silang quorum, forum, it was me, chosen as the first heir. And chosen also by my auntie to be the trustee of her, according to her, her little estates in California. And she wants me to go to California, but I cannot go because of them. What are the other topics? So, our draft. Is my suggestion quite okay? I think it is very systematic, clean, clear, okay. Time bounded and attainable. Even if they come late, the other voters, but it is not good for you to go late. It will be clean, clear, honest, true election. Irregardless of my candidacy. I do not give my right to Globa. As I've said, by the way, he is just like Duterte. I'm sorry for that, Sir Neil. You are also a weakling, and I know you will also be like Bebeb Noel, like Ma'am Pinilda of Asian Dev. There is money given to you and everything will be okay. You will still be under the spell of the Romualdician zombies because of the money. It's not because of their potential to become good leaders or their being good leaders. You may say so. If you may say so, it is because of the money. And that money that I do not have. Because even my own money, thou, Sangguni Ambayan, cannot fight for the truth. We cannot sit for one session. Why? That President Obama said, that Tangaris in Tacloban City He was thinking that Sangguniang Bayan is in Manila, the Congress. Or there was hearsays, or the Bugak ko, no, went to Congress in Manila. Because they double the identity, they are saying, I am the Bugak. Who is the Bugak? Who is the mafi here, mafi here, mafi dignity? Huh? It is Cristina Romualdez. She is waiting for our documents. The stealing of documents is her power. She don't have anything. It was not me who went to the Congress in Manila ever. It was Cristina Romualdez. So, if the way I could understand it, it is the Sangguniang Bayan here, na, because I went there. Do I look tanga? If Cristina Romualdez cannot face me, she run away from me. Every time I go there, she cannot face me. She make excuses. If I have an appointment to Vice Mayor Yao Kasim, she came around. I will not talk to her. Huh? She don't have ethics. She don't have proper etiquette. I have an appointment to the Vice Mayor. Why she is anticipating I will be talking to her? And because I did not talk to her, she will say, I am weakling, I am lump, I am afraid of her. Excuse me. Then she left. And I keep on waiting for the Vice Mayor. And Vice Mayor, we also have that revelation of millions of money Cristina Romualdez is getting from the IMF, International Monetary Fund, in my name. So my name is drug. I have the right to speak up, but why are you not giving me that right? My tarpaulin had been removed. I have a promise to Tacloban that if I be registered in Manila, I will come bringing to you the tarpaulin. That is the sign I am registered. So three tarpaulin. One is here in our terrace. One was in Astrodome, stolen. One was in Alang-Alang, stolen. Why? Is it me who is insecure? Is it me? And why should I? Look at my tarpaulin. It's very nice. It's very simple. Right? That's what they said. It's unique. It is attractive. Shukran, Jazil. I'm like, hmm. I will stop and continue because we have to read this one to explain once and for all. We already ran the time for 1 hour, 3 minutes, and 35 seconds.